watching The Highlight Zone with Wayne 15 Sports Director Glenn Marini. Local sports coverage you can count on.
Just gotta get a little bit better each day, maybe a little bit farther along, and just keep going.
We're New Haven, you know, we don't back down from any challenges as we never have.
We talk to these guys a lot about being humble and being hungry, and these guys have really bought into that.
We're gonna play to the buzzer, all right? And we're gonna play hard.
At the end of the day, still two baskets in the court. We're just gonna go out and play.
Oh, the last time we saw Blackhawk Christian on the Highlight Zone, they were hoisting a state championship trophy at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. But that was last year. And this year marks the 25th season of basketball here on the Highlight Zone. And what a way to tip things off. The newest member of the Highlight Zone team, Colton Howard, joining us with your Highlight Zone Game of the Week. Colton?
Hey, thank you, Glenn. Same classification, but different expectations. Blackhawk is up to 2A this year, but the Braves could compete for a state title. That came into tonight's ranked fourth in the state in 2A polls. Now, on the other side, New Haven's been strong out of the gate. The Bulldogs have wins over Woodland and Northrop, but both being by double digits. Blackhawk Christian at New Haven. It's your Highlight Zone Game of the Week. To Armstrong Arena we go. Blackhawk led by 6'4" junior Caleb First. Reigning national champ Virginia was in Fort Wayne earlier this week to check him out. Tonight, it's Purdue's head coach Matt Painter. We'll get to First later, but first, it's Zane Burke for three to open up the game. Bulldogs off to a slow start, but not for long. Lewis to Jakar Williams in the corner for three. He has it, and New Haven's bench is absolutely loving it. Look at them celebrating right there. From the top of the key down low, it's Burke to Caleb First, who finishes it with a two-handed slam. Yes, First getting the crowd into it, and they're excited. Standing ovation to the second quarter. Donovan Lewis drives the ball in, pump fakes it, and gets the ball to float on the friendly drop, giving the cheerleaders something to cheer about going into the half tied at 31. Now out of half to quarter number three. Woods, layup is no good at first, but First with the putback one-hand slam, he's absolutely on fire. In the fourth quarter, Blackhawk now in transition. Burke, once again, floats it up to Caleb First, who slams it home with the alley-oop slam. And Blackhawk goes on to win it on the road, 74-58.
I was proud of how our guys responded, you know, and I give New Haven a lot of credit. They were ready for us. I thought they played very well in the first half. And second half defensively, I thought we really set the tone, and we just made life very difficult for them with the way that we guarded. And, you know, that's always the key. When we guard like that, I think we'll be tough to beat. I thought Caleb was very assertive in the second half. First half, we challenged him at the half because I thought he was a little passive at times, and we need Caleb to play with a high level of aggression for 32 minutes.
At halftime, Coach Jason just told us to go out and play our game. You know, they've kind of knocked us off of what we were trying to do, and we just played a little passive in the first half, so we wanted to go in, you know, play our offense, play our defense, get the shots we wanted, and just, you know, play the way we play.
Blackhawk Christian is off until they face Elkhart Christian next Friday. Meanwhile, New Haven doesn't play again until next Saturday when they're at Olmsted.